Hi, this is Russell Stanley from teachertrainingvideos.com, and today I'm going to look at three different ways of creating flashcards when you're working with Quizlet. And we're going to look at how you can simply search for flashcards, how you can create your own flashcards, but also how you can bring in lists from outside, from an Excel spreadsheet or from Google Translate, and create flashcards in that way as well. So let's get started. Okay, so I'm logged into Quizlet. Quizlet is a free tool that encourages you to upgrade, of course, like many of these things, but it is a free tool. I'm just going to simply click on search, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to search for cards that other people have created, and I'm going to make a copy for myself so that I can then share them with my students. So I'm going to write English transport. Let's imagine I'm looking for a fairly low level. I just do a search, so I'm just using the search button up here at the top. Press enter, and then lots of different cards will come back. Now, the whole idea of Quizlet is that you're sharing the content that you create so other teachers can use it. So really, a lot of the time, we don't want to reinvent the wheel if the cards are already made. So we can look through here from that search and see if there's any cards that look interested. And I noticed this one here, 15 terms, and we've got a word and a picture. I know that there's one missing there, but I can edit that anyway. So I'm going to click on those. And what I can do now is immediately I can click on here, customize. And I'm basically going to make my own copy of these cards. So I'm just going to simply add to that Russell, because he's going to become my cards. Okay, and then I'm going to click on create. And now that study set has been added to my list of study sets. I can share them, share the link with a student straight away. But the next thing I might want to do, once I've done that, is I may want to edit them. So I'm going to click now on the edit button, brings me into edit mode. And what I can do is I can go through these cards and make any changes that I want to make to them. I can delete some cards if there's a particular card that I don't like, for example. This one here, motorbike, has got the picture missing, so I'm going to just delete that. So, and if I wanted to add cards to this list, I can also do that at the bottom. So let's just give you an example. I can click on add, and I'm going to write, so for example, yacht. And let's see if we can then, on this side, all we're going to do is just find the picture. So we're going to click here. We're going to get pictures of yachts, and that will do fine. And now I've just added a new card with the word and the picture. And in this case, we're not using definitions. And I would click on done. Those cards are mine. They are now part of my study set. If I click over to the right here and click on your study sets, I will see Russell's English for Beginners. I can click on those. And of course, if I wanted then to share them with my students, well, the easiest way is to click on the share button, send the students that copy, that link, and give it to them. Or if you're doing it on Twitter or Facebook, etc. So that's the first way that we can create cards. That is that we copy cards from other people. We might edit and change them, add, take away, but basically it means that we don't have to reinvent the wheel. And that is actually a way that I often work. Now, a lot of teachers and a lot of students like to make their own cards. Now, me personally, I don't use this second way. I tend to use the first way and the third way that I'm going to show you to make cards. But let's just look at this second way. So we're going to look at create. And what we'll do is, first of all, we need to give a name at the top. So what I'm going to call this is, I'm going to call this Polish to English, and we'll do food, okay? Now, I'm studying Polish myself at the moment, so it's quite useful for me to do these cards. So I've given them the name, and now I need to start to add the cards. Now, what I'm going to do first is choose a language. So I'm going to click on choose a language, and I'll have Polish. And in fact, what I'll do is make that, just going to change that. I'm going to change that to English. So I do English as the main language, and I can just write it up here and it will come up onto the screen. So I'm gonna have English as this language here, and this side I'm gonna use the definition. I'm gonna use Polish. Now, we don't have to use definitions. I personally like them, and it's normally easier when you're creating cards to use your base language, your first language, as the language on the left hand side, and then get Quizlet to help you find the words. So we're going to do food, so we're going to keep it very simple. Let's start by simply doing, let's work around salads and stuff like that. So I'm going to do tomatoes. Now, what will often happen is the word will come up, And then it's going to give me the word in Polish. I'm going to click on Pomodoro. And I can also add a picture. Don't worry about the science sound. That's going to be automatic. And as I'll show you in a minute, I'll just do a few cards. So that's done one already. Now I'm going to come down to the next one. And I'm going to do another word here. So let's do, for example, cucumber. So again, let's just start finding the word. Click on here. The word's going to come up on the other side. I click on it. And again, I'm going to click here on the picture and add a picture of a cucumber. And I'll just do one more. So this time we're going to do lettuce. So just again, clicking down. Word's going to come up on the left-hand side. Click on it. And then I'm going to put the same word on the right-hand side. And I'm going to choose this one here. And then let's just do perhaps one more. Let's just do potato. So again, coming up. And then on the right hand side, the word's going to come up. And again, and I forgot the picture there. So let me just come back to that one first and add in a picture. And then let's come to this one here. And again, let's add a picture. And I'm done. That is it. I'm only going to do four cards for this. You can add more cards if you want to. All you need to do now is click on the create button. Those cards are produced. Again, immediately you're given a link which you can copy, share with your students, perhaps if you're using Edmodo or something like that. But of course you can add the cards to their class if you've already got classes set up. And the next thing I just want to do with these cards is quickly test them just to show you something. So I'm going to click on flashcards and now the cards are open. And make sure you click on options. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to answer with English. And I'm going to click on advanced here and I want the English off and I want the Polish on and I want the speed to be normal. So let's just quickly test these cards. We can hear the card in the word in Polish and then it's perhaps too easy because I've got the picture with it. It might have been easier to put the picture on the English side. And then of course I've got to translate. I can click and then I've got the word.
Ogórek.
Ogórek, and then again I can translate. So that's how you can create your own cards. Remember, you need to click on that button there and notice that the audio is automatic. Lots of people ask me, Russell, how do you add the audio? The audio is added automatically. Remember, you don't have to use a picture if you want to, and don't forget as well, you don't necessarily have to do just one word. And in other videos I talk a lot about how I actually use complete sentences and even do things where the first sentence is in English and the second sentence in English, but it might be the present and the past. So lots of more creative ways of working, not just simply translating words. But that's the way to create your own cards. Now the third way is the way that I actually create cards. Now I'm studying Polish and when I'm in my class I have Google Translate open because Google Translate is a free tool if you have a Gmail account. You can even find it on your browser. If you write Google Translate it will come up, but it's great if you've got a Gmail account because it works in a slightly different way. It will actually save all the words that you find and search for. So as I'm doing my lessons or after my lessons, I will open up Google Translate and go through the vocabulary that I've learned. So I'm just going to open it up now. And I've got a couple of words that I've learned in the last couple of days that I want to put into my list. The first one is especially. Okay, so I'm just going to write the word in English. It's going to come up in Polish. I'm going to click here, plus. Okay. That means it's now been added to my list. Remember, because I'm logged into my Gmail account, it will remember my list. And I'm going to do one more just to demonstrate this. And the word I'm going to do is difficult, okay? Trudny, correct? Again, I'm going to add that to my list. I can even listen to the word by clicking trudny. Here, okay? Now, what about if I want to see all the list of words? So I can click here. And I'm going to choose all the words. I'm just going to get all the English to Polish words. And there's 26. And what I'm going to do is, and this is the great thing, I can now bring those words straight in, or not quite straight, but nearly straight into my Quizlet and start to study them. So how do I do that? Well, I just simply click on this button here, and that is going to export those words, or it's going to actually bring them into what we call Google Sheets. There they are. And I've got the great here, I've got the word in English and I've got the word in Polish. Now what I'm going to do, I don't need these two columns. So I'm just going to right click there and just click on delete column. Because I don't want the word, I don't need those. And I'm going to do the same here, delete column. So that I'm just left with the list of words and the translation. Okay, now in this case, I'm quite happy. You can always edit things if you need to change things or anything. I'm just simply now going to click on the first one and click on Control A, or you could just say select all. That would have done exactly the same thing. All you want to do is select all the words, and now this is the brilliant thing. So I'm just going to copy all those words. I'm going to copy them. So just copy. Now I'm going to come back to my Google, back to Quizlet, and I'm going to create a new study set. So I'm going to simply call this one here, New Vocabulary May 2019. And I'm not going to add in any words here. I'm simply going to click here below, and it's going to say to me, well, what are you going to do? And I'm going to just simply paste. I have the word in English, space, word in Polish, and that will be enough. And I can even see that it started to create all the words underneath. I click on import, and that is done. I have now got a list, and what I love about this list is related to what I was doing in my class. Now some people say to me, oh Russell, Google Translate, but in our experience, especially working with just one word or just a simple phrases, Google Translate is really reliable, and generally the words that it produces as the translation are absolutely great. It might be more difficult if you're using long phrases, but certainly for translating words, and see how easy that is to do for me. And I love that relationship between what I'm doing in the lesson and adding these words into Google Translate, or after the lesson, and then bringing them into Quizlet to study and play games with them. So those are the three ways to create cards in Quizlet. I really hope you found that video useful. Please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. Lots more free material. I deal with all sorts of tools here at the top, and that includes Quizlet with a complete introductory course. Below you've got stuff about different themes, flipped classroom, feedback, autonomous learning. If you want to keep up with my work, two things that you can do. Firstly, if you want to know about all the latest content, best thing is to sign up to my newsletter. That way you'll learn about all my courses, you'll learn about any articles I've written, you'll also learn about any new videos that I've created. And the other thing to do is to sign up to my YouTube channel. It's really growing. I think we're up to around 7,000 followers. Don't forget to click on the bell. If you click on the bell, that way you will be told when new videos have been uploaded. And thank you very much. And finally, if you'd like to continue your studies, I've provided you with three links to three sets of videos that I think you might find interesting. And thank you very much.